I heard about discipleship many years ago, but it was very scary and a big mountain to me. And the Lord used different things in my life to bring me to that place where I started searching and asking Him what was it going to look like in my life. My husband passed away in 2009, and in 2011, the Lord brought two girls to live with me, and that changed my world. We lived life on life, literally, one for 6 weeks and one for 2 years. So that was really fun, and that kind of whet my appetite. And then I was introduced to Downline. I came to Downline with the attitude, I'm not going to sit just with my friends. I'm going to meet some young people. I'm going to get to know them. And the great thing about that was they were here from all over the United States, and they wanted to meet people. So my first encounter was with the girl that I walked out to the hall with and asked her Thanksgiving plans, and she didn't have any, and I said, come to my house. And that resulted in me discipling her the rest of the year. But I gained such great relationships with about six girls. One girl came up to me and Susie Davis one day and said, can you teach us how to cook side items? There were two girls. We said, sure. So they came to our kitchens, we cooked and we laughed and we sat around the table and they wanted to know everything about us. And we told them how we met our husbands, how about our children, because they wanted to know those kind of things. That core relationship with those six girls have carried on even to this day. I had two of them at my house last night for dinner, taco soup, and talk. It doesn't matter what you feed them. They just want to talk and visit. And it's been a lovely, lovely time. I think the biggest thing for my life since I got out of Downline and just giving the Lord my time is that He has shown me ways to involve people in my everyday life. I've had them in my home with my family. They needed to get away from situations sometimes. They've spent the weekend with me, different ones at different times. And even my daughter said one day, we never know who's going to be at mom's table or in her beds. Come, let's sit around the table and eat and tell me what's going on in your life with discipleship. Who are you reaching out to? And to see that be followed through, that they're reaching girls, just to live life with them and enjoy it, but keeping Christ at the center. And it has been a total life transformation for me. I love being with them. I love that my grandkids watch what I'm doing. And they love those girls. They want to know if the Rose or the Kina or the Lachelle are coming for Thanksgiving. They want to know it's part of their family too. And I think it's what it's all about. One thing that I had to conquer was a fear that what if these girls asked me something or wanted to know something I didn't have a clue about. And many times I've had to say, let's pray about that and I'll get back with you. Sometimes they've walked out the door and I've gone on my face and said, Lord, I am in over my head. But the key that I have found is God honors the fact that I spend time in the Word. He's given me a passion to read the Word. I don't know all of the answers, but the answer is His Word. And so often, and it's just a miracle to me, that I can read a passage in the morning and it's that very word that I'm able to give out to someone that's in a hard place and say, have you thought about this? One day, a couple of girls came into my house and one girl was just pouring her heart out to me and I said, that reminds me of something I read in Scripture. The other girl pointed to her and said, I told you she would have a Bible answer. But it's not my doing, it's absolutely the leading of the Holy Spirit, because I can't remember what I was supposed to do yesterday or tomorrow. It's just the prompting of the Holy Spirit and being available to do the next thing that He leads me to do. I don't have the degrees, I don't have seminary, I don't have any of that. But the very Holy Spirit that was with Jesus is in me. And that's what I have to remember. It's not by my power and strength. It's by the work of the Holy Spirit.